Well, I've arrived safely. As you can see, I've just left sunny Thailand. If you haven't seen it, check out part one of this two-part series. I've come from Adelaide, here for a new startup. I've come to Manila to check out call centers and outsource staffing solutions. This is about a 20-minute video on how to safely navigate around Manila, an emphasis on safely. There were a few sketchy parts of the trip. I've managed to collaborate a lot of the city into this video, so if you've never been, you can still get the experience that I got. It was fantastic to see a different part of the world. I really enjoyed it, but even stepping outside of the airport, I became a target. So just a word to the wise. Guy came up to me in a uniform saying he worked for the airport and he was gonna take me to my hotel. I thought, great, let's do it. Took my bag and followed him back into the airport into an office. I was fortunate enough that I had a contact prior to the trip and he said it would be about 600 pesos using Grab. Grab's similar to Uber, but we'll get to that later. So when he gave me the bill, it was gonna be 1900 pesos. I was like, oh, hang on a minute. It's gonna be 600 pesos using Grab. He's like, oh no, there's no internet reception at the moment. You wouldn't be able to get a Grab even if you wanted to. Plus we'll give you a receipt so you know the exact amount is locked in. I was like, nah, dude, that sounds dodgy. Don't worry about it. So I went back out to order a taxi or a Grab. Another woman came up to me in a uniform saying, hey, we offer a similar service, but I'll do it for 1300 pesos. And I said to her, you know what? It's my first time in the city. I would prefer to use a company just because I haven't used anything before. But I'm not paying that. I'll do 1,000 pesos and that's the most I'm going to do. She said, yeah, no worries. I'll radio a taxi and we'll get started. So Grab is similar to Uber in regards to that it's a mobile app that you download. Grab is really popular here in the Philippines. And the difference between the two is that the prices won't fluctuate depending on the time of the day or the traffic. So if you're slammed, it's still going to be the same price, which is great value for the consumer. Turns out there's another thing called Grab Share, which is, as you can see here in a moment, it's a slightly reduced rate and the driver can then pick up other Grab passengers. So really, to be honest, for if you're from the States or from Australia, it's less than a dollar difference. So you're actually just better off just doing a Grab on its own. But this was the first time I got it and I didn't realize I'd had the button ticked. So for next time and for the rest of the trip, I made sure it was just singular Grabs. But at the same time, it's great you get to meet other people as well. The lady that got in wasn't really chatty. I don't think she spoke much English, so it is what it is. But no, it was great to see the city, and that's why in this I videoed a lot of it, just because I didn't get, as this was a business portion of the trip, I didn't really get to do a lot of tourist things. So for me, the tourist part was actually just driving around the city, going in between meetings. So you prefer Grab over Uber just because you can pay by cash?
Uber is almost credit card.
All credit card, okay.
And there's a lot of passenger.
Yeah.
In Grab because middle people.
Yeah, everyone has cash. So I'm Dennis's first ever Grab passenger. So thanks, Dennis. So what is this called?
Camote. Camote queue.
Camote.
Oh yeah, Camote queue.
It's good. Yeah, it's good. Thank you. Joey.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, Joey. Yeah. All right, so Joey's showing me around, microsourcing. Oh, thank you.
Shoot the money now.
Bitch, you looking at the one. I'm the best yet, and yet my best is yet to come. Cause I've been looking for somebody, not just any fucking body. Don't make me catch a body, that's for any and everybody. Oh my God, she hit me up all day, no response. Bitch, you blow my heart, that's like turning gold to bronze. Roll my eyes, and when she on the molly, she a zombie. She think we Clyde and Bonnie, but it's more like Whitney Bobby, God forgive me. Told you F and S and I'm a legend. Straight up out the crescent, fly your bed down for the essence. For the record, I know Cali when that ball was spinning records. Move like game winning record, I'm just flexing on my asses. Yeah, you're looking at the truth, the money never lies. I'm the one, yeah, I'm the one. Early morning in the dawn, know you wanna ride now. I'm the one, yeah, I'm the one, yeah. Hear you sick of all those other imitators. Don't let the only real one intimidate ya. See you watching, don't run out of time now. Don't you know, girl? Don't you know, girl? I am the one for you. I'm the one.
I'll make this one quick. Pretty knackered after 5 hours of sleep last night. Got through a fair few meetings today, which was good. It was very productive. I've picked a place that I want to work with for now, but if something comes along tomorrow that's better or cheaper, then we'll definitely go for that. So yeah, we'll see how tomorrow goes.
Well, what's all this then?
That's a dog. Well, how's that for customer service? Thank you, Armada.
Now, the city itself is very diverse in regards to the standard of living. One end of the spectrum is stricken with poverty, so much so that the rate of the homeless population in Manila alone is 3.1 million people. This is the largest homeless population of any city in the world, and this includes children. Yet on the other end of the spectrum, there are currently 2,000 billionaires walking around, and 14 of them are from the Philippines. Plus, there's others like famous boxer and Senator Manny Pacquiao with an approximate net worth of $190 million.
Thanks, Ron. Thank you.
We
when you do walk through the city, you have to be very careful of scam artists and theft. The poverty here is very real. So as a light example of that today was some guys asked if they get some photographs with me because I was Australian. They also asked if I could sit in their horse cart and then get some photographs that way. The guy then tried to start taking off in the horse cart to drive me around the city, which I then jumped out while it was moving. He then said, oh, I'd also like some money because you took photographs with us. That obviously wasn't going to happen. I decided in the end I'd give them some, or a few pesos, but he actually asked initially for about 50 pesos, which is the equivalency of a 3K cab ride. So just be very wary when you do walk through the city, and when you do turn these people down, still be polite about it because you don't want to get robbed, and that can really happen in some areas of this city.
I've managed to do one tourist thing, so I'll count that as a win. I'm very happy with that. The zoo's very close to my hotel, so short walk. It's only 4:30, and I don't know if it's the area, but it's a little sketchy. I felt uncomfortable enough to button up my rear pocket where my wallet is. But I'll have a bit of a walk around, and hopefully I don't get rolled on the way home. Try and get home before dark.
Ooh, some animals have escaped.
Meow.
It's a tiger.
Rawr.
You've got to feel bad for the seals at the zoo in Adelaide. They get less of a space than these fish.
Good thing it's fenced, you know, in case it wanted to bob its head under and all. Oh, there it goes.
I'm just kidding, it's fine. The $2 entry really secures these animals. Doesn't look like it, but it's got a massive forehead.
Look how prehistoric these things look. They would claw your eyes out. Huh. Hello, fellas.
So we're in the reptile house, and I noticed this guy, and then as my eyes wander, I notice these little fellas. I hope they don't get eaten alive.
At night, the city of Manila comes alive. Once the sun goes down, the atmosphere completely changes and a different city blossoms. If you were going to explore, this is the time when you want to leave all your valuables back at the hotel and equip yourself with minimal cash. If you're staying in the center of the business district, different story. But where I was staying, in Makati, I was pre-warned. I found it unsettling that over the course of the trip, several beggars grabbed my arm in an attempt to catch my attention, asking for money. Some I did feel more sorry for than others. For instance, I met an American man that had come over to retire, and over the course of his stay, his money got wasted on, we'll say, pleasures. It's easy to become swallowed up by the city, even if you're a Westerner. So although everything is cheap over here, just be careful what you spend it on.
I've been, you know, it's just having a bit of bad luck, you know, a spot of bad luck, that's all. So,
yeah.
You know, once I get through it, I'm trying to get back home. So once I get through this, get back home, you know, there's nothing like the food you grew up on, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah. No. Well, yeah, all right, well, enjoy the food.
Well, thank and, you very much.
All the best.
It was very kind of
you. My pleasure.
All right. Take care.
Well, that concludes a week-long business trip in Manila. It was a very interesting experience. I would definitely come again. Make sure you subscribe below to continue following the journey. All in all, amongst the chaos, the city really seems to flow and come together. And aside from some serious issues, it really is a wonderful place to see. I'm Ross McFarlane, and thank you for watching.